Hello everyone, this is Shreesh from SkyMom and today I am going to explain you about arc. Okay, so in arc here we are having n number of methods to draw the arc over here. Okay, so here you can see I'll drop down this arc. So here you are having 3 points: start center end, start center angle, start center length, start end angle, start end direction, start end radius, center start end, center start angle, center start length, and last one is continue. Okay, so first now here I'll explain you about one by one each method. Okay, so now here what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a situation okay so now just imagine I want to draw an arc over here. Okay, so here you can see I'm having 3 points, exactly 3 points, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so that time here what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the arc method as 3 points. Okay, select this point as first point, this as second point, and this as third point. Okay, so here you can see you'll get an arc perfectly within these 3 points. Okay, so next after this, next method here you are having as next method as start, center, end. Okay, so the method itself is saying me first I am going to mention the start, then I am going to mention the center, then I am going to mention the end of the arc. Okay, so select this method and just select this as start point, then the center, and specify the end point. But you can see here instead of getting my arc like this, you are getting it in the opposite direction. Why? Because whenever you are creating the arcs over here, you are going to create it anti-clockwise. In the sense, like if this is your start point, if this is not your start point, the opposite point means the end point will be your start point of the arc. Okay, so here what I'll do is I will select this as my start point, this as center point, and then I'm going to mention the end of the arc. Okay, so you can specify the end of the arc however you need. Like for example, if you off the ortho, you can adjust it more or less. If you on it, then it will come straight like this. Okay, so next after this, next you are having the next method as start, center, angle. Okay, so here what I'll do, again this I'll mention it as start, this I'll mention it as center, and then I'll mention it as angle. Okay, so like for example, you can see here 90 will come, one year 180 will come, year 270, and year 360 degree. Okay, so like if just imagine if you need the arc to be ending at 45 degrees, so I'll mention the angle as 45, I'll click on enter. So till where the 45 degree comes, till there you will get an arc. So you can just check it out here. So here, select angular and select this point and this point. So you can see the angle is 45. You can see the angle is showing as 45 degree. Okay, so the next method after this is start, center, length. Okay, so again here you are going to mention the start, then the center, and mention the length of the arc. Like for example, I'll mention it as somewhat around 5. So you can see the length of the arc will be 5. Okay, so next after this, here you are having start, end, and angle. Okay, now instead of mentioning the center, here you are going to mention the end. Okay, so mention this as start, mention this as end, and mention the angle of the arc. Okay, it depends on how much angle you are going to give. Like for example, if I am going to give it as 180 degree, so you will get a correct semicircle. Okay, so next over here, we are having start and direction. Okay, so here this is only one method which you can mention it as clockwise or else anti-clockwise both. Okay, so here I'll mention the start. Start end and I'll mention the direction, so you can get it up as well as you can get it down. Okay, if you off the ortho you can adjust it how much ever you need. Okay, so next over here you are having the next method as start end radius. Okay, so here again I'll mention this as start, I'll mention this as end, and I'm going to mention the radius over here. Okay, so my radius is somewhat round 2.5, so I'll mention it as 2.5, enter. Okay, so you can get, you got a correct semicircle over here. So similarly now again here you're having center start end. Okay, so in this method it is saying you to mention the center first, then the start, then the end of the arc. So mention this as center, mention this as start, and mention the end of the arc. Okay, like this. So next here you are having center start and angle. Okay, so mention this as center, then the start, and mention the angle of the arc. Like for example I'll mention it as 90 degree, it will get over. So next one is center start length. So center start, and I'll mention the length of the arc as 5 again. Okay, so you got the arc length of 5. So the last method you are having as continue is nothing but the last point where you have left the arc. From that point here you will get one more arc like this. Okay, but here what you can do is you can't specify a